In part 6 of our lesson on trigonometric equations, you will learn how to solve for all possible degree solutions. Here, we have to solve for all degree solutions. We are given negative sine theta is equal to cosine of 2 theta. So we have a couple different issues here. We have two different trig functions, and we have two different arguments. Now we know that cosine of 2 theta has three different identities that we could use. Because the left side of our equation has a sine theta on it, we want to choose to substitute in for cosine of 2 theta 1 minus 2 sine squared theta. The left-hand side will remain sine of theta. Now our entire equation is in terms of sine theta. So we have the same trig function and the same argument. We gather up all the terms on one side. Because the sine squared over here is negative, I would want to move that over to the left-hand side to make it positive, so it will become positive 2 sine squared theta. We still have minus sine theta. And the 1 is positive on the right-hand side, so when it comes to the left-hand side, we have to write minus 1 equals 0. We are ready to factor now. We can make our parentheses, set it equal to 0. To get 2 sine squared, we're going to take 2 sine of theta times sine of theta. To get 1, we know we're doing 1 and 1. We need a negative sine theta as our middle term, so that tells us that the 2 sine theta needs to be negative, and the 1 sine theta will be positive. We apply the zero product property to get that 2 sine of theta plus 1 has to equal 0, or sine of theta minus 1 has to equal 0. To solve this first one, we should start off by subtracting 1. So we have 2 sine of theta is equal to negative 1. Divide both sides by 2, and we get sine of theta has to be negative 1/2. We use this to make a picture. We know that if sine of theta is going to be negative, then that means that theta is going to be in quadrant 3 or quadrant 4. We go to our special angle chart into the sine row where the value is 1/2, and we see that our reference angle is going to be 30 degrees. We know that to get the quadrant 3 angle, we put theta r in quadrant 3. So we will have to take 180 degrees, which is here, add in theta r of 30 degrees, and we get 210 degrees. If we put theta r in quadrant 4, we know we have to start here at 360 degrees, and we back up by 30 degrees. So we will be at 330 degrees. So from this first equation, we will get theta is equal to 210 degrees plus, remember, we're finding all degree solutions, so that means we have to name every angle coterminal with 210. Going all the way around means we have to add 360 degrees times n. Remember, n is an integer. The second solution here is that theta could be 330 degrees plus 360 degrees times n. So these two are the solutions to that first part of the equation. In the second part of the equation, we would add 1 to both sides, and now we have sine of theta is equal to 1. When we draw that picture, we know that means that theta has to be up here at 90 degrees. So then theta, when we name all the possible solutions, theta will be 90 degrees plus all the infinitely many angles that are coterminal, so we have to add on that 360 degrees times n. So these would be all the solutions to our original equation. In this example, we have to solve for all degree solutions. We are given the equation tangent squared theta plus 2 tangent theta minus 3 is equal to 0. And where necessary, we will round our degree measure angles to the nearest tenth. All the terms are already gathered up on one side, so we can go right to the factoring, put in our parentheses, set it equal to 0. We'll need a tangent theta times tangent theta to get that tangent theta squared. To get 3, we know we can do a 3 and a 1. Now they have to combine to give us positive 2 tangent. So we need the 3 tangent theta to be positive, and we need the 1 tangent theta to be negative. We're going to apply the zero product property, and we have that tangent of theta plus 3 is equal to 0, or tangent of theta minus 1 is equal to 0. Solving this first equation, subtracting 3 from both sides, we get tangent of theta is negative 3. If the tangent has to be negative, then we know that theta has to be in quadrant 2 or 4. Three is not one of our special angle values, so we will use our calculator and we will have to evaluate the tangent inverse of negative 3. So we make sure that our calculator is in degree mode, and if need be, hit the DRG button to get there. So we are going to enter second tangent inverse of negative 3. The tangent inverse of negative 3 is equal to negative 71.6 degrees when we round to the nearest tenth place. We know we can't use a negative angle as our answer. We always put our answers in the positive form, but this does tell us that our reference angle will be 71.6 degrees. If we put that in our picture, in quadrant 2 here, we know that we will do 180 and subtract that 71.6, and we get 108.4 degrees. Now here, in quadrant 4, to get this angle, we put theta r in there. We know we would be starting from 360 degrees and backing up by 71.6 degrees. If we do that subtraction in our calculator, we get 288.4 degrees. Now, these would be the only two answers if the directions for the problem said solve between 0 and 360. But that's not what the direction said. The direction said solve for all degree solutions. So that means there's going to be infinitely many solutions. Every angle that is coterminal with 108.4 degrees is also a solution. And every angle that is coterminal with 288.4 degrees is also a solution. Now you can list your answers as theta equals 108.4 degrees plus. Now if we're in degrees, we know going all the way around, we can't say 2n pi because that's radian measure. Going all the way around is 360 degrees, so you could say plus 360 degrees times n. And to get all the angles coterminal with 288.4 degrees, you would say theta equals 288.4 degrees plus 360 degrees n. Now, if you like, you may also combine these two in this special case. Oftentimes with tangent, we notice that the two angles are opposite rays of each other. And we know that opposite rays are 180 degrees apart, this way or this way. So it's also okay to format your answer as a single answer and say theta is 108.4 degrees plus 180 degrees n. This is actually how most mathematicians would state their answer, but it's also okay to say it like this. So either form of the answer is acceptable. You get to write a little bit less with this one if you notice that they can be combined because they're 180 degrees apart. Turning to our next equation, we're going to add 1 to both sides, and we now would have tangent theta is equal to 1. We draw that picture. We know that tangent theta being positive means we're going to be in quadrant 1 or 3. This is one of our special angle values, so looking at the special angle chart in the tangent row where the value is 1, we see that theta r is going to be 45 degrees. So if we put 45 degrees into quadrant 1, of course that's 45 degrees there. If we put 45 degrees into quadrant 3, we know we have to add 180 plus 45 to get 225 degrees. Because we're finding all possible solutions, that means we have to name all the angles that are coterminal with 45 and all the angles that are coterminal with 225. So once again, you could state this as two different answers and say theta equals 45 degrees plus 360 degrees times n, and theta is 225 degrees plus 360 degrees n. Perfectly acceptable to state your answer that way. Or, once again, these two angles are 180 degrees apart from each other. When that happens, that special case, you can combine them together and say that theta is equal to 45 degrees plus 180 degrees times n. So in this case, you're starting at 45 degrees and only going halfway around to land on the next one. So you would start here at 45, go halfway around, then you would land on 225, then you would go halfway around, and that's how you would proceed, halfway around, halfway around, halfway around. Where with these, you would start at 45 degrees and go all the way around to land here again. Go all the way around to land here again. So this would give you that series of angles. This one, you would start at 225, go all the way around, all the way around, etc., to get that series of angles. It's great if you can see this combined version, but if it makes you very uncomfortable, you are welcome to write it as the separate pieces, because both of these sets of answers will yield all the solutions.